Hi folks, welcome back to Advance Wars. Okay, next field training mission. Copter tactics. It's time to introduce air units. It appears that we have a problem. Orange Star has hit a snag in its medium tank development program. On the other hand, Blue Moon seems to have more than enough tanks. I think it's safe to assume that they have mass production capabilities. I pulled some strings and had some B-copters and T-copters sent down from the front lines. But that doesn't give you all that much for more firepower. Nevertheless, let's make good use of them. I'll give you more details once we reach the staging area. Let's move out. Mission 7. Olaf is one shrewd guy. Look at the units he is deployed. He's always one step ahead of us. I didn't think we'd have any air units. I didn't think he'd have any air units. I guess I underestimated him again. But, as I suspected, he has deployed a number of medium tanks. A frontal attack would be reckless. As always, we need to defeat all enemy units or capture their HQ. But looking at all of Olaf's units, I think we have only one true option. We must capture the enemy headquarters. First, can you select this infantry unit? The enemy HQ is right below you. But infantry units can't cross seas. It might be possible to march there, but with all of those enemies. This is where transport copters come in handy. Do you remember APCs? Like APCs, transport copters can carry infantry and mech units. But also like APCs, they have no weapons and can't fire. Okay, go ahead and load a unit onto your transport copter. Good, you loaded your troops. Now, select the transport copter. Now, look where it can move. That's right, transport copters can move overseas. Plus, the movement cost is the same over all terrain types. Okay, let's move it down here. Now, drop the infantry. This is the only place you can drop troops now. Do you know why? Infantry can't move on the ocean. You can only drop infantry on the terrain they can move across. Don't forget that. You should check to see on which terrain you can drop infantry. You remember how to check terrain? Right. Move the cursor onto the terrain and press the R button to check it. Give it a try. Okay, now let's test the battle copter's capabilities. Select it. The battle copter is an air unit, just like the transport copter. This means terrain doesn't affect its movement range. Air units aren't affected by terrain bonuses either, which makes sense since they're always flying. As for attack power, well, you should check it out for yourself. This tank is in the perfect spot. Test your B-copter, fire! aren't they powerful? Battlecopters are even effective versus tanks. Plus, with their superior movement capabilities, they're easy to deploy. Now, let me tell you a little more about your new copter units. As you know, they're both air units. All the other units you've used up to this point have been ground units. Since air units are always flying, they use fuel every day. The battle and transport copters use 2 fuel units per day. Don't worry about remembering that exact number though. Just keep in mind that they burn fuel every day. Now you know all you need to know about these new units, right? I'm leaving the rest up to you. Do you want some strategic advice? Pay careful attention to the enemy battlecopters and medium tanks. All we have that can go toe-to-toe with them are our battlecopters. So play it safe and get them out of an attack range until necessary. Other than that, don't forget to capture the enemy headquarters. Tomorrow, I'm sure Olaf hasn't considered the possibility that it could be captured early on. Good luck. Okay. So they can move. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five spots and fire about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if they reach here, they cannot fire. Here, so I must hold them for one round. Well, this. Gas 93. Okay.
Oh, I see Nell hasn't deployed any medium tanks. Go, my troops. This time, nothing can stand in the way of our victory.
Okay. No worries. Now I should just yield. Right. Excellent. Okay. I should be able to win next round. Okay. I kind of wondered about this before, but Olaf typically makes terrible use of his units. It doesn't matter how good your units are if you don't know how to use them. Anyway, let me tell you a little more about those new air units. Even if you land them on allied cities and headquarters, they won't recover HP or be supplied with fuel or ammunition. You haven't seen any yet, but you can only resupply air units at airports. If they run low on fuel or ammo, you can restock them with an APC, just like land units. Now, keep up the good work.
What in the... My headquarter has been stormed. Nelly, you troublesome little... You saw that you couldn't survive a frontal assault, so you pulled this out of your hat. This isn't over yet.
Way to go, Anson, you won. Okay, next mission. This air assault. This mission deals with air units, fuel consumption, and anti-air defenses. Good news! Orange Star's medium tank development team has succeeded. Plus, you're also given some new and improved anti-airs. Now, let's discuss the current operation. An entire company has disappeared on its way to the front lines. It was made up mostly of medium tanks and tanks, so this is serious. It may mean that they ran into an air squadron complete with... Forget it. It's nothing. I'm sure I'm just reading too much into the situation. Well, time to get moving. Mission 8.
Nell, mobilizing your troops again, are you? Well, you're too late. Fly my masters of the sky. Finish off these surviving troops, then destroy that meddlesome nose.
I see my fears were well founded. He's got bombers and fighters too. This is bad. All of our units that were deployed here have been decimated. If we don't stop off here, he'll push onward and cause even more damage. This is a major turning point. We must be strong. First, let me tell you about a new unit which has been assigned to you. You've seen plenty of medium tanks, so you know how to use them, right? Against other ground units, they're practically unstoppable. But, as you have just seen, they're helpless against bombers. Okay, now let's look at this anti-air unit. Let's see what they can do. Select this one, please. This battlecopter is in the perfect spot. Attack it. Anti-air units attack air units directly, so move it over here. Okay. That's what anti-air units can do. You can see how overwhelmingly powerful they are against air units. Plus, against ground units, mech and infantry in particular, they're more effective than tanks. However, tanks will defeat them in head-to-head combat. Now that you understand anti-air units, I'll let you take command. Do you want some strategic advice? Yes. Watch out for fighters, bombers, battlecopters, and medium tanks. It appears the fighters and bombers don't have much fuel or ammunition. I was nervous at first, but we may get through this after all. With air units, you have to watch how much fuel they have. I already told you that copters use 2 fuel units per day. The other air units, fighters and bombers, use 5 per day. If they run out, they crash and the units are lost. Try to make the most of this intel. Let's talk more on strategy after the bombers and fighters are gone. Good luck! Okay. survive till the planes are all crashed. Well, let's see. This is the only way. Come here. No, I have one medium tank. So perhaps I should try to sacrifice a few infantry units. Bring it here. Then take this one, because this one can't reach here. So I can take this one here and wait. This one closer. And it's just okay, let's see what happens. Well, that was very unfortunate. Okay, so they will crash soon. Let's take this one here, fire. Let's drop you here. Thank you.
Okay.
If I had known that... fighters will go out of fuel, then I wouldn't have make that mistake. Okay, now for some more strategy. First, the battle copters. The simplest thing to do is to use your infantry as decoys. Use them to draw the copters toward your anti-air unit and attack. If you can take out the battle copters like that, then the fight is ours. As for medium tanks, try to trap them and pound away with your artillery. Once that's accomplished, you'll be in complete control. If your air units look low on fuel, you can resupply them with an APC. I told you that already, didn't ya? Well, anyway, the rest is up to you. Good luck. So I must, I wonder if you do the stage again, the mission again, the AI will repeat everything, or will it actually adapt to what you are doing? Let's destroy this. Good. so long. Almost. Oh, I can finish him this way. Right. One medium tank and one artillery left. I should use copter.
Great. Should heal these. Interesting. Okay. Closing them.
Okay, so next time I will lure those tanks down. When they come, I'm going to use all my firepower. Okay, this should get them moving. Okay, let's just wait. Let's see what happens. But now I can shoot you. Okay, this should be over now. Goodbye, Olaf. Well, we have learned that Olaf has readied his bombers and fighters. The fact that he had no clue about keeping them supplied saved us. Good luck in the next battle. Keep up the good work.
He forgot to refill the fuel tanks. What are you fools thinking? Is it that hard to refuel an aircraft? Oh, just wait until next time.
You did well, Anson. A rank. Nice. Alright. Let's continue next time. See you then.